In this video, we're going to be covering the hollow body hold. This is a calisthenics core exercise everyone should master. I'm going to be teaching you perfect technique so you can avoid common mistakes most people make. And I'm going to be showing progressions from beginner to advanced so everyone can level up over time. Let's get into the video. You're probably thinking, why should we be doing hollow body holds? Easy. Here are the benefits. We're going to be developing anti-extension core strength. We're going to be developing some potential for hypertrophy in our ab muscles, building some muscle. And we're also going to be developing just general body awareness and body weight mastery. Hollow body holds, many more benefits, but those are a few of the key ones. I'd like to cover technique for perfect hollow body holds, starting out with incorrect and then correct. I find that most people learn best when finding out what to avoid and how to do it perfectly. In terms of universal technique that you should apply regardless of whatever hollow body hold progression you're up to, this is what you want to keep in mind. Most importantly, we want to start with the core position and ab bracing. Most people doing hollow body holds, they get fatigued, and the common mistake that people make is they arch their lower back. This completely defeats the purpose of what we're trying to do. To perfect your technique, you really want to hollow out your core, brace your abs, and keep this engaged throughout the entire set. Now, a small but important detail with hollow body holds is breathing, because this feeds directly into core and ab engagement. What I mean by this is I want you to be taking forceful, deep breaths in and out of your stomach. This is going to fully engage your ab muscles and really feed into getting a strong contraction. So it might sound like a small pedantic detail, but these little things add up to perfecting your technique. What feeds into optimal technique is what you're doing at your upper back and also your shoulders. Most people, when they get fatigued and they get tired, it's very normal. They tend to just rest back, but this is incorrect and it doesn't fully engage your abs. Instead, for correct and optimal form, I want you to perform a mini crunch. So basically, while you're in the hollow body position, literally just get your shoulder blades off the ground. This is going to do that upper crunch motion and fully engage the abs and make sure that you can get the most out of the hollow body holds. Okay, so a cheeky little mistake that a lot of us fall into is neck position. So what happens is we get a little bit of the gooseneck happening. So we get fatigued, we're not using our deep neck flexors and extensors. So most people tend to just default into this desktop PC looking position like this. It's not optimal for just general positioning and also the ab engagement. So although it might look just as funny, I really want you to make a double chin. So you're going to tuck your chin in and look towards your feet. This is really going to get that anterior ab engagement, and you're not going to look like a goose, because who wants to look like a goose? Let's take a look at hollow body holds from the top down. So you'll notice that I've got my arms extended straight overhead. This really helps for that full body tension and stability to make sure that we're focusing on what's happening at our abs. Next up, you can see that we're in a fully elongated hollow body position. So conventionally, you want to keep your legs squeezed together, and also that is going to feed into that full body tension. So we're taking essentially a two-pronged approach from top down to create that full body stability, and that's where the hollow body hold truly shines. When it comes to manipulating exercise difficulty for calisthenics, we're playing around with leverage. So for my beginners, the regression to start with is when you're in a tucked position. Over time, intermediates should progress towards a longer lever, which is a 45 degree position with the legs. And of course, you guess where this is going. As you get more advanced, you want to go closer and closer towards the ground, and this lengthens the lever. Basics physics applied, difficulty increases, your abs get stronger, everyone wins. With our hollow body hold exercise, we're trying to develop anti-extension core strength. So beginners, an easier way to get connected with your body position and mechanics is to start with your arms by your side. This is going to help you with doing that mini ab crunch and also holding the hollow body hold. Of course, over time, I really want you to progress towards arms overhead, because that's going to increase the challenge on the core and also your ability to get stronger. An excellent progression for my more advanced people that are looking for a challenge is the weighted hollow body hold with the weight at your hands. This is a great way of increasing the difficulty of our conventional hollow body hold whilst getting some extra benefits. This exercise has excellent carryover to other calisthenics exercises. In this example I want to give you, think about a muscle up. Our hands are moving through the exercise while our body remains still. So we've got all this shoulder movement, stuff happening at our hands, and during these demands, we need to have our core braced in a hollow body position to optimize the exercise. We want to use exercise that replicate the demands of calisthenics. So in this case, we're maintaining that core position whilst our upper body is moving. This has great functional carryover to what we're trying to improve. And the beauty of it is you can keep progressing it over time, increasing the weight, increasing the time under tension, adding in tempo manipulation. This is why it's perfect from beginner to advanced if you want to be moving towards better core control. Another excellent variation for my more advanced people is the weighted hollow body hold distally at the feet. This is going to be excellent for training towards calisthenics moves where our hands are fixed and our legs and body is moving. Think about a handstand push-up. Our hands are fixed and we need to develop the core control in addition to other attributes in order to maintain that position. If we want to get these adaptations, we need to load distally at the legs in order to develop the attributes that are going to have good transfer to our goal. So all you need to do is put a weight at your feet and then perform dynamic hollow body holds where you're extending your legs and coming back. You're going to be gaining that core control, that anti-extension control that's going to have excellent carryover to all things calisthenics, and you're going to build a essentially bulletproof core. Regardless if you're a beginner just starting your hollow body calisthenics journey or you're someone who's advanced, here is the prescription or principle of training I want you to apply. Literally 3 to 5 sets of around 30 to 45 seconds, time under tension, regardless of variation, regardless of progression, is going to be perfect for challenging your core in a way that is going to bring enough intensity to get adaptation. Keep it simple, try that out, and you'll be absolutely sweet. That's it for today's video, everyone. Please show your support to FitnessFAQs by dropping a thumbs up below. Also leave a comment. What problems are you having with calisthenics? Let me know and I'll be here to help. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you all very soon.